The number you have dialed has been changed. The new number is... Please note.
Hello. There's a bad glare from the light here. Let's go over here for just one quick second. There, that's much better. Just for a moment. Hello, and welcome to this edition of freddiedotcom cooking. Tonight we are making chicken dumplings. Nothing makes you feel better than some good old country cooking, trailer park, lovin', Bisquick-makin' dumplings. So I am going to make chicken dumplings. I hope you enjoy. I'm sure it's going to be edited down because to sit and watch me make dumplings all night, it's kind of boring. But maybe I'll talk through it. All right, so let's see if I can get... I've got Aquaman on today. Hello, Aquaman! See, that light is just not bothering. This is the kitchen. This is my kitchen, or our kitchen. This is... It's red. I took the shelves, or the cabinets off the shelves, because we bought new plates. We were having Thanksgiving dinner once, and we bought new plates. And so we brought the plates home, those plates that are right behind me. And I went to close the cabinet, and the cabinet wouldn't close. So I said to Jim, I said, well, let's just take the front of the cabinets off. And so we did, and they're sitting in a closet in the hallway. So because we got to put them back on when we leave, if we leave. So, all right. So anyway, so that is the kitchen story. This is the kitchen. You get the idea. So we're going to make some dumplings. Let's see. I wish I... You can see me better over here, right? Hello. So we're going to take... Great for casseroles and cooking Campbell's soup. Yes. Cream of chicken, great for casseroles. Perfect. So we're going to take some of that. And we're going to take... I usually take 2 cans of the cream of chicken soup. And then you can use either chicken broth or water or milk. I like to use milk and chicken broth. I like to use a combination of both, milk and chicken broth, because you get the best of both worlds. I don't know. I just like the way it looks and tastes. So we're going to take that, and then we need some Bisquick. Right here, family staple, country Bisquick. You gotta love it. All right. Yeah, it's Bisquick. So you're gonna take some Bisquick. Oh, look, I have some. Here we go. Here's some chicken broth. Now this, I discovered, I was very... This has the resealable lid. So, you know, it's always a good thing. So you're gonna take that. And, you know what, I just realized I'm out of the shot here. Maybe I should move this just a hair. There we go. How's that? Better? Is that good for you? Okay. I just realized we don't have any milk. That sucks. Okay, this is a good thing about living in New York. When you go to cook something, you can run downstairs and get whatever it is you need. So we're going to pause it right now. We'll do the magic of editing. I really don't like that glare. I don't know why it's doing that. Magic of editing, and I will be right back, and we'll continue with freddiedotcom in the kitchen. Don't move. Hello. We're back. Crisis averted. I got the milk. Can't make chicken dumplings without milk. All right. So what I like to do is... You know, there's many ways to make this. But I like to add some actual chicken to it because, you know, it is chicken and dumplings. I remember my grandmother used to actually, I think, boil a chicken, and then she would put the chicken, like,
you know, she'd actually boil the chicken until the bone, like all the meat would fall off, and then she'd put that in, and so you have all that flavor and stuff. But this is just the short version. So we're going to stick this in the microwave and let it thaw. Hopefully it won't be too loud. Let's see, it's 1 pound. Start. Alright, so that's got 7 minutes. That's gonna be some time to thaw. Now, in the meantime, let's get our pots. Like, there's no planning to this whatsoever. Like, I just decided to make chicken and dumplings. And so then I was like, oh, let's, you know, I'll just do a blog about it. How fun would that be? Me in the kitchen. freddiedotcom in the kitchen. So, we're gonna need that. And I'm going to need, in the handy dandy dishwasher, New York kitchens are not that big. This. Ta-da!
Oh, I can cook too, on top of the rest. My seafood's the best in the town. Yes, I can cook too, my fish can't be beat. My sugar's the sweetest around. I'm a man's ideal of a perfect meal, right down to the demi-tasse. I'm a pot of joy for a hungry boy, baby. I'm cooking with gas, so I'm a gumdrop, a sweet lollipop, a brook trout right out of the brook. Some girls make magazine covers, some girls keep house on a dime, some girls make wonderful lovers, but what a lucky find I'm. I'd make a magazine cover, I do keep house on a dime, I'd make a wonderful lover. I should be paid overtime, cause I can bake too, on top of the lot my oven's the hottest you'll find. Yes, I can roast too, my chickens just ooze, my gravy will lose you your mind. I'm a brand new note on a table d'hote, but just try me a la carte. With a single course you could choke a horse, baby, you won't know where to start. Oh, I'm an hors d'oeuvre, a jelly preserve, not in the recipe book. Some girls make wonderful drivers, some girls can hit a high C, some girls make good taxi drivers, but what a genius is me. I'd make a wonderful driver, I even hit a high C. I make the best taxi driver, I rate a big Navy E, cause I can fry too, on top of the heap my Crisco's as deep as a pool. Yes, I can broil too, my ribs win applause, my lamb chops will cause you to drool. For a candied sweet or a pickle beet, step up to my smorgasbord. Walk around until you get your fill, baby, you won't ever be bored. Oh, I'm a pate, a marron glacé, a dish you will wish you had took.
Super, super good. It's good.